Before the series aired, Ricky Gervais admitted that some viewers had reservations. 106 The first season of The Office received a mixed reception from critics, some of whom compared the series to the NBC short-lived series Pairing, which was also based on the British version. The New York Daily News called it so watered down that only dirty water remains. And USA Today called it a fair imitation of a much better BBC original. A review published in Guardian Unlimited criticized the lack of originality and noted that Steve Carell seems to be trying too hard. Perhaps in later episodes, when he moves away from the Gervais and Merchant script, he will feel more at ease. Distribution in the UK for the American version of The Office Archive July 16, 2006. At the Wayback Machine, TVSquad.com, retrieved April 12, 2008. James Poniewozik of Time noted, producer Greg Daniels has created not a copy, but an interpretation that clearly improves on American work conventions with a more satirical and less scathing tone. The new boss is different from the old boss, and I'm fine with that. 112 He called it the second best series of 2006. After Battlestar Galactica, 112 A week later, Entertainment Weekly writer Mark Harris joined him with Steve Carell's fearlessness, an increasingly strong cast, and a script that perfectly captures the absurd language of corporate America. This underrated remake achieves almost the impossible, honoring the original Ricky Gervais and working on its own terms. Club critic Nathan Rabin commented on the series' evolution after a tumultuous start. The Office improved dramatically and immediately became one of the funniest and most poignant series on television. Before the second episode aired, the writers researched The Office. 20 This process was also used for Daniel's other series, The King of Hills and Parks and Recreation. 20 The pilot episode is a direct adaptation of the first episode of the original British series. 21 Daniels decided to go this route because starting from scratch would be too risky as the series is an adaptation. 21 He briefly considered using the idea of Dundee as a pilot episode. 22 Once the writers met with the cast, they were allowed to write for the actors, allowing the series to become more original in the next episode of Diversity Day. 21 After mixed reactions to the first season, the writers tried to make the series more upbeat and Michael Scott more likable. 23 They also created more supporting characters for the series and gave them relatable characters. The table was shot with a single cinematography style camera to create the image of a real documentary, without the studio audience and laughter, allowing the dry and absurd humor to be fully expressed. 46 The basic premise of the series is that the crew shoots Dunder Mifflin and his staff seemingly constantly. 46 The presence of the camera is acknowledged by the characters, especially Michael Scott, who enthusiastically participate in the shooting. The characters, especially Jim and Pam, also look into the camera when Michael creates an uncomfortable situation. 27 The main action of the series is supplemented by interviews with talking heads, or confessions,
in which the characters talk privately to the crew. 27 Actor John Krasinski shot footage of Scranton for the opening credits after he discovered that
he had been cast as Jim. Archive July 1st,
2017 at the Wayback Machine. New York Times, February
13th, 2008 accessed April
12th, 2008 Daily Show's Carell may star in Office remake archived February 2nd, 2011 at the Wayback Machine. Entertainment Weekly,
January 29th, 2004, when Andy discovers that Dwight and Angela are continuing their affair. The two-man dumper, the newly hired vice president,
Charles Minor, introduces a strict store management style, forcing Michael to resign in protest. 84 Michael opens Michael Scott's paper company in the same
office building and hires Pam and Ryan as salesmen. And although his business model proved unsustainable, Dunder Mifflin's profits are immediately threatened. 85 After the acquisition of Michael Scott's paper company,
all three were rehired.
Pam was promoted to sales manager and Ryan returned as a temporary employee. He later left that position when he wrote a comedy series